Okay, on number one, we're talking about John's apple orchard here, and I'm gonna do that work down here at the end of the page. So for number one, part A, excuse me, we are gonna go ahead and talk about John's apple orchard here. The profit he will make depends on the number of bushels he grows and sells. So he makes $25 per bushel, but must subtract $300,000 for costs associated with growing the trees in order to calculate his profit. Write an expression to represent the profit he will make. So in order to make money, he's gonna sell apples at 25B, so $25 times per bushel of apples. But you also have to take out the cost for his operating expenses and everything, which is $300,000. So 25B minus 300,000, where B again is the number of bushels. Okay, so that starts it off. That's how we're figuring out Josh's profit then. Now, at the same time, if you wanna be able to stay in business, it says on part B, he must make at least $80,000 . So he doesn't want to go below $80,000, but at the same time, he does not want to make more than $250,000. So at that $250,000, he does not want to go above that. So you can walk up to $250,000, but you can't go above that. So for part B, that's the compound inequality. He wants his profits to be between $80,000 and $250,000. So how many bushels then is he gonna have to sell? So in part C is where we are going to now solve that compound inequality. So let me take, wrong button. Copy that, paste it. Let me do a better copy of that. Okay. So we're gonna solve that equation for B now. We're gonna add 300,000 to both sides. And also in the middle, because of this compact form here, we need to add it all throughout. That gives me 380,000 on the left. In the middle, just 25B. And on the right, 550,000, okay? Then we're gonna go ahead and divide everything by 25 to get B by itself. 380,000 divided by 25, go to your calculator and divide that. So that's what I am doing as well. I get 15,200, B in the middle. 550,000 divided by 25 is forgot that, 22,000. So he needs to sell between 15,200 bushels and $22,000 bushels. So between 15,200 and 22,000 bushels to be in his sweet spot. And on part D, it says to finish it off by graphing the solution. So not gonna be anywhere near to scale. So at 15,200, we are closed. At 22,000, we are also closed. So you wanna be, say, above 15,200, you wanna be below 22,000. And that sweet spot is where it overlaps as a compound inequality with the word and in between it. So this is again where we wanna be, the sweet spot. So what does that mean, John? Needs to sell between 15,200 and 22,000 inclusive, so include those as your possible solutions, bushels of apples.